They always do that when you take, if you wave your hat or something to them, they wave back. You never forget it. Because yeah, there's a lot of China shipping, Cisco. If you look at this one right here, China shipping.
Wow. Oh yeah.
And I found out where they do the loading of these things. Down this line where it's going now, way at the other end has a little thing where it can pick up the these and put them on.
Oh, no way, really?
Oh yeah, they use it. I saw them loading up a train. And sometimes, if you're lucky, one of these trains will be on this line, going out that way. Down. That the train has to wait until the railrunner clears. At least the railrunner has the top priority.
Yeah.
But I feel sorry for Amtrak. Whenever they get to LA, they have to wait on the freight train. They don't get to go ahead. They have to wait on the freight train to come through. They don't get priority up there.
Oh, damn.
Because that's the hub. It's Los Angeles. It's where all the trains start before they come here.
Yeah.
Before they head out to Texas and on. Board. Have you ever heard of the Fort Worth and Western in Texas? It's the Fort Worth and Western. It's a train that takes from this train onwards.
Really?
Yeah. If you ride the Grapevine Railroad, you meet up with the train. If you ride the 2248 Puffy.
Ah, really?
Yeah, they actually got a 460 and been running on their line. That used to belong to SP.
Oh, no way.
Yeah. It used to be at the Texas State Railroad Museum for a while. And then originally before, they used to do a fire patrol. They used to send the engine out with a tank car with water to spray the fires.
Yeah.
And after that, went into retirement until the flu time ran out.
On the way.
And then the Texas State Railroad bought it, restored it, and ran it as their number 200.
Wow.
Now it's 2246. It's been numbered three different times.
On the way, really?
Yeah. So yeah.
Thank you.
CSX is here. Thank you. Sound check.
Thank you.
this track here. Oh, he switched. Where's on track? Huh? Jeez, two guys track. From the train.
Thank you.
get this. Sure. Thank you. Well, I guess let's get started. Sound check. Mic check.
Oh, great, it froze again.
Sound check. Mic check.
Oh, great, it froze again.
I got one of these guys to honk to me yesterday. He blew his horn for me. Yeah. Yesterday until 7 o'clock at night, catching freight. I can get back to my hotel until at least 9 o'clock at night. I had to walk all the way back there.
Oh, here, back here somewhere.
A Holiday Inn over at by I-25. I had to walk all the way over there with luggage, filming equipment. So yeah, I walked it.
That's over by the exit.
Yeah, you know where I-25 is, where you get onto the on-ramp.
Exit.
Oh, yeah, that's right. There is a railroad restaurant up there, huh?
Penny's restaurant.
Yeah, that's where I'm staying. I'm right over there where the BNSF guys stay.
Okay. Oak Tree Inn or whatever it is.
That's Oak Tree Inn. Travelodge Oak Tree Inn, yeah. I'm at the Holiday Inn. That's where I'm at. Right next door. Have you ever tried Pete's Cafe yet?
Sorry?
Pete's Cafe, that's over on the other side right by the Harvey House.
Right across the street there?
Yeah. It's good. I tried it last night for dinner and it was good.
We were talking about it on the way down today.
You should try it. It's good. And their prices are reasonable. So that's good. I think this train has a rear engine and two engines in the back with their headlights on. This one that's leaving out of the yard. I saw headlights behind one of these cars.
I got a feeling this guy's going to be in the front of the alcohol pit, probably 45 miles.
Mm-hmm. And yesterday I got a yard tour of the yard. Yeah.
Cool.
The guy was nice enough to drive me around the yard to see what it looks like. It's big from a vehicle perspective. Yeah, it's nice. I saw the roundhouse. I got to see everything.
Cool. This is having a place. It's the real deal.
Yeah, see, in Albuquerque, where I came from, there's not much BNSF action there anymore. They did away with them. They have the engines there, but they don't run them. Unless they had to, I guess.
So they've got a north switch job that runs at night.
Yeah?
That I actually saw in the daylight about a week ago. But it came up on me to get me pictures.
See, I used to film the Lamy Local that used to come through Albuquerque. That's what I used to do. Now they're not coming through anymore. They bypass us and go a different way. The next train that's at track one is ready to go. He has his lights on. So I think he's going to be ready to come out when he clears. Because look, he has his all three lights on. So once he's in the clear, the next one will come out. Yesterday I saw a North Fork Southern, CSX, and the BNSF. CSX was the lead engine. I got that one. He was coming outbound. I was over at the railroader platform when I saw him coming. And I got him real quick on a digital camera before the battery went dead.
Okay.
And the only thing is I forgot to bring the charger for it. I left it at home. I didn't even know I left a lot of my equipment back at home. Notice that lead locomotive's hissing too much? And look, they have their doors open on the cars, the engines. Each engine yesterday had all the doors open. I wonder what they're doing. Unless he's going out to get help to eastbound, which he might be, because he's heading out. Oh, I see what they're doing. Actually, no, they don't. You can go up to that switch right there and then switch over. It's easy.
Well, I think this guy only has to come out to here to back up to get back to the train.
Yeah, but he can also take this track to track two.
All the way out there.
Yeah, and then meet up, and then they will come back. That's what they did yesterday.
Except he stopped on the switch.
Oh, yeah, he stopped on that switch on that side, but I think he can, if he came there and went to a certain point, what he would do is probably back up and reverse. I see what he's doing. He's going to back up here, go that way, back to the train, and then he's there. Look, he's going. NS is going. Out there. They're going to meet up at some point. Yeah, see, he came onto track two, this guy that was going backwards. And then I think what he's going to do is he's going to switch onto track, whatever track number that is over there, and then they'll couple up. And they're going to probably need all the power with those cars.
Yeah, if that's all loaded grain, that's a big train.
Oh, yeah, it's grain, tank cars. Another thing. Hey, look, train's coming in on track six.
New train on six.
Unless, maybe that's the eastbound that came in and we missed it. So did you ride the railroader out here or something, or what? Or you drove?
We drove.
That's not bad. Hey, at least you drove out here to see action out here. I was standing on that platform yesterday until late. Oh yeah, here it comes. CSX is behind us. turtle bug here in Belen instead of Albuquerque. Looks like there's stuff under there. Birds. Here's the doodle bug. It has a wreath in the front of the engine, so yeah. It was moved all the way from Albuquerque with 6 engines. There's no motor in the doodle bug. So they had to use 6 engines, and they did not have brakes on this thing. So they had to use all the diesel power they could to get it over here, and their lights are still up there. But yeah, thought you'd like to see it. Doodlebug. Here in Belen instead of Albuquerque. Looks like there's stuff under there. Birds. Here's the doodlebug. It has a wreath in the front of the engine, so yeah. It was moved all the way from Albuquerque with 6 engines. There's no motor in the doodlebug. So they had to use 6 engines, and they did not have brakes on this thing. So they had to use all the diesel power they could to get it over here, and their lights are still up there. But yeah, thought you'd like to see it.